Straight across, going to the press conference that's being addressed by Amitesh Kumar, who is the Pune Police Commissioner. This is, of course, regarding the Pune hit and run horror. Let's listen into what he has to say.
अभी दो आरोपियों को अरेस्ट किया गया है, तीसरा आरोपी का प्रोडक्शन वारंट की कार्रवाई की जा रही है, विचार पूछ और पूरी इंटरोगेशन अरेस्टेड एक्यूज्ड का और सभी प्रकार की टेक्निकल एविडेंस हस्तगत की जा रही है। जो भी इसमें दोषी पाया जाएगा उसके विरुद्ध कार्रवाई की जा रही है।
सर, जो रिपोर्ट आई है, दोनों और ससुन की हो, फॉरेंसिक रिपोर्ट, उसमें अल्कोहल ट्रेसेस को लेकर क्या रिपोर्ट सामने आई है?
देखिए, ससून हॉस्पिटल की सैंपल तो उस व्यक्ति का था ही नहीं, इसलिए अल्कोहल आना या नहीं आना इट इज एन इररिलेवेंट फैक्ट, बट उसमें अल्कोहल नहीं आया। औंध की रिपोर्ट ये डीएनए के दृष्टि से ली गई थी, परंतु औंध की जो सैंपलिंग हुई थी वो अप्रोक्सीमेटली 18 to 20 आवर्स के बाद की सैंपल लेट नाइट आवर्स में ली गई थी, इसलिए उसमें किसी प्रकार का अल्कोहल आने की संभावना नहीं थी, किसी प्रकार की अल्कोहल की कंटेंट उसमें नहीं आई। जी नहीं, ये हमने बार बार बताया है, शुरू से हम बता रहे हैं कि ये केस कल्पेबल होमिसाइड नॉट अमाउंटिंग टू मर्डर का है। ये केस 304A अंतर्गत रैश एंड नेग्लिजेंट एक्ट का नहीं है, जिसमें कि अल्कोहल की कंटेंट रेलिवेंट फैक्ट होती है। हमारे इस केस में अल्कोहल की रिपोर्ट इज एन इररिलेवेंट फैक्ट और हमारे इन्वेस्टिगेशन को किसी प्रकार से डिरेल नहीं करेगा, किसी प्रकार की कोई अड़चन नहीं आई।
सर, आपकी जनरल इंक्वायरी चल रही थी, क्या उसमें अभी पिज्जा बर्गर वाली कहानी स्टैब्लिश हो पाई, क्या वो सब दिया गया था?
हमने ये बताया है कि जो प्राथमिक तौर पे जो दोषी अधिकारी पाए गए थे वो उनके ऊपर कार्रवाई की गई है। इसमें प्रत्येक दिशा में तपास और इंक्वायरी शुरू है, जो भी कोई दोषी पाया जाएगा उसके विरुद्ध कार्रवाई की जाएगी।
लेकिन सर,
मैंने ये इस विषय पे ऑलरेडी बताया है कि हमने सीसीटीवी फुटेजेस हमने लिया है ससून का, जो भी बात सामने आएगी सीसीटीवी फुटेजेस के अनुशंगा ने उनके ऊपर कार्रवाई की जाएगी।
All right, that is, of course, Amitesh Kumar, who is addressing the media. Remember, he's the Pune Police Commissioner. This is in terms of the action that we have seen, but also big statements being made by the top cop, saying that the minor's blood sample was replaced and minor's sample was thrown in the dustbin. Shweta, my colleague, joins me over the phone line. Shweta, this is one of the allegations that was being discussed about ever since this horrific incident had come to light, but now with the top cop confirming this.
Well, absolutely. In fact, this is seen as a major development in Pune case, where we understand that the doctor has been arrested under several serious allegations. Now we see that it is confirmed that there was altercation being done at the forensic lab with the testing samples of blood of the minors.
Right, Shweta. Thank you very much for getting us more as far as the fact that this is a big, big breakthrough that is coming in terms of this particular action. Remember, even Dr. Ajay Tavde, who you, of course, see in the visuals on your screens right now, he was arrested for tampering with the blood sample. And when that was, of course, put across to the top cop of Pune, he has gone ahead and confirmed the same. In fact, he has said that the CCTV footage of this particular hospital in question, that is the Sasun Hospital, has been seized. But more importantly, the fact that the Pune CP has confirmed that the blood sample which was replaced didn't have traces of alcohol, but also had one separately which was sent to the private hospital, also didn't have traces of alcohol, and that not a private hospital, they've given the sample now to that particular government hospital, we understand in question. But more importantly, with the fact that now this is a big breakthrough with the minor's blood sample being replaced, is what Amitesh Kumar, the top cop of Pune, has stated. He's also gone on to make an imperative point that minor's sample was thrown in the dustbin and the doctors replaced the minor's sample, which is why we saw that action earlier of the doctors being arrested for tampering with the blood sample. Essentially, we continue to track the latest as far as this is concerned. Remember, this is a big, big breakthrough as far as this entire matter is concerned. As far as we talk about what has happened earlier as well in this particular case, that the Pune crime branch, remember, had arrested two doctors. The hospital's forensic chief was arrested. The chief medical officer was also arrested. This is the arrest over tampering with evidence, which has been confirmed now. The hospital in question also is under scrutiny. In fact, this is a major twist in this case, where the two doctors were earlier arrested for allegedly destroying the evidence. Now that allegation, which has been coming to the fore since day one, has now been confirmed. Let me take that point across to my colleague Abhishek. Abhishek, this is something that we were talking about earlier as well. These were allegations, but now with the fact that you were also in that press conference, Amitesh Kumar, the top cop, confirming these allegations, a big breakthrough.
Definitely, you know, that is what in the initial press conference, Pune Police Commissioner has said that, you know, he has taken deliberately two samples. In fact, he wanted to be confident and sure about them. And he had a suspicion earlier that there were attempts made to manipulate the sample, which he suspected. And during the press conference, he also said that, you know, after the initial report of initial blood sample, which didn't have the traces of alcohol, and through intelligence inputs, I had confidentially collected another sample of the accused and also collected the sample of the father of the accused and sent it to another government hospital, which is on the hospital in Pune. And as the report came out yesterday, where, you know, those two blood sample of the on the government hospital, DNA matched, but it didn't match with the report of the sample that was out by the Sassoon Hospital. That's where suspicion was, and later the dean, the head of the forensic department, along with the CMO who took the blood sample, were taken into custody. They were detained, and after questioning, it was revealed that initially the blood sample was collected by the Sassoon Hospital of the minor accused only, but later that was thrown into the dustbin, and someone else, another person's blood sample was collected, and that was executed. And that's the reason, you know, the DNA sampling of the one sample that was collected in Sassoon Hospital and the other sample confidentially collected and submitted to the Andh government hospital didn't match. And that's where the doctors were detained and were questioned. And what also been revealed in the press conference by the Pune commissioner is that continuously Vishar Agrawal, father of the minor accused, was in touch with the doctor who collected the sample and were planning the entire conspiracy to replace the sample. So he has been made an accused in the first FIR also. Now remember, trouble is mounting on Agrawal family. Now finally, Vishal Agrawal, the father of the accused, has been made accused in all the three FIRs. And now he is currently into judicial custody for the second FIR, but will be taken into police custody back after filing an application in court today. And two more FIR, in fact, the initial FIR where his name has been added now for criminal conspiracy, for giving gifts, for bribing those doctors, and 120B, these all sections are now been added. Now, in the first FIR, apart from the minor accused, you have two doctors who have been accused, and one Vishal Agrawal name is also been added. So total four accused, including three accused, including the minor accused, when it comes to the first FIR. So definitely, this is now highlighting the cover-up that has consistently been done by the Agrawal family from the day one, which was exposed by the Times Network. And now this has only been confirmed by the Commissioner of Police, Pune, who also had a suspicion on the blood sample and which came out to be true. And now those doctors have been arrested and investigation is into progress. In fact, we also asked him the question whether there was involvement of the police inspector and assistant sub-inspector who have been suspended, whether there was involvement of the MLA, Mr. Tingray, who was present at the spot. So he pointed out that investigation is going on in the all angles. Whoever will be accountable for any crime in this will be punished, will be booked. But as the investigation progresses, we will have to look into the all angles. And we are examining the CCTV of this currently. So who was the person whose blood sample was collected? Lastly, both the blood sample, you know, whether the sample of Sassoon Hospital or the sample, the real sample of the minor accused at the on the hospital. Both didn't have traces of alcohol, on which the Commissioner of Police clearly pointed out our case is not relying on that. We have a watertight case. Other technical evidences we have gathered, which will definitely help us to prove the case of 304, culpable homicide not amounting to murder. And we will be able to prove that, you know, that minor accused was well aware of the intent of crime he is going to do, which has cost two precious lives. Back to you.
Right, Abhishek, thank you very much for helping us better understand where this case stands. But most importantly, as far as you also were tracking this development, how this big breakthrough has now impacted the overall case. But for the moment, we'll have to leave it to that.